standing between you and the exhibition. And so I promise not to be too long. After I've just said a few words, we're going to be led to have a look at it for ourselves. I can't be the only, I'm an ageing lesbian. This is one of those few places and moments in history where that's like a positive thing. I feel like my subconscious mind is more active than my conscious mind, and I'm full of this extraordinary sense of wow, what a wonderful thing we've all achieved to bring about such extraordinary social change. 60% of the population are even going to let us get married. I mean, it's getting totally out of hand. So at one level, it's like, my God, we're still here. It's 40 years, and it's bigger and better than ever. And there's another part of me that has all the spirits of the people who aren't with us. You know, because I'm old. I remember the explosive joy of the protest and then the terrible scourge of HIV/AIDS. And I remember the Sydney Star Observer when it was all, you know, memoriams. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. And so when I go in there, we see faces, you'll see faces of people who are no longer with us, and that is acknowledged in the exhibition. So I'm both exhilarated and in a funny way deeply moved. And that I'll try and reflect just a little bit of that in my introduction to the exhibition. And I want to, in a way, dedicate my remarks to two people I met yesterday. We're so acceptable now that ABC Kids, that's a television station for children. I was once trained as a primary school teacher and told because of my sexuality I could never be allowed in a school. But we have now reached the point where ABC Kids are making a program with primary school and early high school children in it, which will be broadcast shortly. And I was interviewed by school children yesterday in a studio. A rainbow support group at the school, and the teachers brought them in to be part of this event. So I've got the year 12 girl and I've got the year 9 boy, and his name was Bradley. And Bradley was so obviously gay that in the 60s and 70s he would have been, if I may swear, I look at the director because I'm still a nerd. And you know, he would have been bashed shitless over and over again. He was naturally flamboyant. At one point, they asked me to bust a move, this was the language used, in front of a camera because everyone else had busted a move. And I said, I'm 63 and I'm a nerdy lesbian, I don't have a move. And then, determined that I'd have a move, like this is a rolling ABC camera. So I said, Bradley, come over there, do something behind the camera. And he got up and he just flung himself around. Now, why am I telling you about Bradley? Because that's what this exhibition is about for me. Yeah. You know, it's Bradley and this other young woman whose name was Sophie. It's them going in there to see it that I'm thinking of. But let me stick with Bradley, because in my first year at gay liberation, it was all men. It was a year before, this is 1974 in Lesbian University, before a girl came in, and then we had sex, because we were the only two we knew. It's a true story. She's now, of course, an aging senior public servant. My point is, what our artists have done is they're telling our story, and I profoundly believe that only we can be trusted. And I think it's fantastic there's a museum of love and protest, but I look forward to the day when there's a permanent museum here in Sydney. Yeah. Glorious creativity, but also its solid protest art, which you'll see what you're about to see. And if any of you have ever been to Jerusalem, Yad Vashem is an extraordinary museum to the Holocaust. And I don't mean any disrespect to Jewish people. I was there, in fact, on a Jewish Board of Deputies United Church tour. I'm deeply engaged with those communities. But we need our version of Yad Vashem. We need our, you know, where we can have exhibitions and fight with each other because we won't agree on anything. But it still will, you know, depict this extraordinary journey. And why do I want it? It's not just because I want to feel part of a multi-century movement for equity. It's not just because it somehow celebrates and reinforces our success in advocacy. It's much deeper than that. I have to acknowledge that Winston Churchill and Julius Caesar, do I have to explain who those people are? They wrote their own histories, terribly important. We can't trust people to write it for us. But when we see this history, when we see this creativity, the posters, the photographs, and the remarkable costumes, and thank God there's a lesbian with a decent costume in there. it goes deeper than that. It somehow builds and nurtures my identity in a very profound way, and it will for Bradley too. Like, Bradley was born gay. When you meet Bradley, you know it. He would have had a feather boa at three. it's a deeply psychologically positive thing for me to go through in there. Let me just get a tiny bit more specific before I leave you. Because I focused, I guess, on the joy, but I want to mention the work that perhaps, well, two works that speak to me very deeply. And one of it is the work by David McDermott. And for those of you who haven't seen it, in the early 90s, he did a series of extremely individual and very unique looking. I'm not an art person, I'm sorry, but they're special, aren't they? I mean, they're quite distinctive. And they were, I think, commissioned by ACOM, presumably. Yeah. And they are graphic depictions of male homosexual sex, and it was designed to get people to not die of HIV/AIDS. I mean, that's another one, isn't it? And I remember, I'm the girl who had a whole year in gay liberation only with men. And so, you know, I remember that era, and I remember it so vividly, and I remember the candlelight parades. And when I see those images, one, I'm so proud of Australia. I'm so proud that the gay, lesbian, transgender community engaged with the health system and created some of the filthiest health education in the history of public health. I don't think anywhere else in the world embraced the challenge of saving lives with as much creativity and commitment and fairness. Would that be wrong? Can anyone back me up on that? And they're absolutely embodied in his work. And I just thought it was so thrilling to see it there. The other work I'd like to... I beg your pardon?
We still do lead the world.
Okay, fantastic. Thank you. Give that a round of applause. I guess the other work I'd like to particularly highlight is, as it's already been mentioned, it's the recreation of Malcolm Cole's 1988 Captain Cook costume. And to me, the long-term engagement of Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander people in Mardi Gras, I think, has had a much higher profile in recent years. Would you agree, Graham? Obviously with people right up the front of the march, but also there's just a greater respect and acknowledgement, and that's very clear at the opening of this exhibition. But I just think, I guess what I'm trying to say, and I've got to be quick because I've already gone over time, so it's 2 or 3 minutes, but creativity is our protest. You know, I was one of those aging lefty, well, I was young then, but I was a serious lefty. I am embarrassed to tell you that I didn't think the celebration was a good idea. This was just an example of how I totally lack political judgment. And I still do. Because when Ron Osborne and Margaret thought, let's have it as a celebration, let's have it as a Mardi Gras, it was clearly a critical turning point that has actually changed Australia forever. But at heart, it is still a protest. And I think what we see in there is truly creative people expressing that protest, that fight back against the narrow confines of gender identity in the most extraordinary way. And with the Captain Cook costume, it's also asserting sexual identity and cultural identity, and in a way saying, up you, Captain Cook. I mean, I think gentlemen who had their way with each other on the boat. You know what I'm saying? I mean, this was a hideous place for homosexuals in the in our early days. Anyway, I won't go into a digression on history. But let's just say gay sex wasn't treated well by the redcoats here in Australia in its early days. So I just think it's fantastic to have that powerful up you with all the assertive gay flamboyance of that marvellous costume. But I'd like to close by mentioning a work that was commissioned, as we've heard, for this exhibition by Gareth Ernst. Thank you, Gareth Ernst. And it's called Wolf. And you'll see it out there on the ground floor. There are two stories. If you go out the back, we, in a sense, enter a darker world. Perhaps it's more like the party world than it can be late at night. But there's a commissioned work that is about a group of friends who go to Mardi Gras dancing after the Mardi Gras party, and one of them the next year has passed on. And his ashes mixed with glitter were scattered on the dance floor. And it is a very striking work and a very moving work. And I guess I want to draw attention to it because in this 40th year, as well as welcoming young Bradley and young Sophie, these school children, and trying to convey some of the joy and pain and flamboyance and grit that we've had to get where we are, I want to remember the poor buggers who didn't make it. You know, who are, there are ghosts in this place. This was a prison, this was also a mental hospital. There would have been plenty of masculine women and feminine men who got stuck in here for not good reasons, you know. So this area is both our territory, I mean, it's your territory, but it's our, if you don't mind, we can share it in a sense tonight. This is where we've gathered and done naughty things in the darkness. But it's also a place we've suffered. And I go back to Yad Vashem. I want our museum. Yes, it's great in Green Park that we have a pink triangle that acknowledges, I've been to Auschwitz, we were there too. We were there too. But we want more than a pink triangle in a park because the young don't get that. They need the help of the curators and all the people that you listed, the wonderful skills that you have here. So I hope I haven't spoken long enough, but I think Miss Gingham, if I may call her that, will lead us to the event. But happy Mardi Gras and let's enjoy this wonderful event.
Yeah, right.
Make sure to.